Everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting. This is Absorption versus Variable Costing. This is part 7. We're going to convert variable to absorption costing. How exciting. Let's go ahead and do it. Okay, so we've got LGA. And by the way, this is much more of an academic exercise, I think, than anything else. However, I think it really helps you kind of cement the concepts that we've been going through and looking at. So LGA had the following variable costing income statements for the years ended December 31st, 2025 and 2026. They use FIFO for inventory costing. Using the information below, prepare absorption costing income statements for LGA for the years ended December 31st, 2025 and December 31st, 2026. And then they want us to identify the differences. So we're given these variable costing income statements and we have to go figure out what it is in terms of absorption. Now, a few different things that we want to kind of look at over here. So, but let's first start out with our sales. So our sales under absorption costing. Okay, I know that my total sales are going to be $17 million. This is 12/31/25. I also know that my per unit sales price is $850. If my total sales are 17 million and my per unit is 850, that means that when I took my units times my per unit, that's how I got to my total. So my total units that I sold were 20,000 units. Very important number. Okay, so I sold 20,000 units. What's the next thing I do? I take my cost of goods sold under absorption. Okay, so if I'm using FIFO, okay, now let's kind of take a look at this. So over here, my ending inventory had 5,000 units. My units produced this year were 19,000. So over here, when I'm going to go take these 20,000 units, I'm going to first take 5,000 units from my ending inventory or the beginning inventory. Because remember, it is FIFO, first in, first out. So my beginning inventory in units were 5,000. Now, my cost per unit for these 5,000 units, I have to go down here. Now, for my variable cost per unit, remember that my variable cost per unit only is going to be including direct materials, direct labor, and variable overhead for my total cost per unit of 402. Now, it also gives me this information here that my fixed factory overhead per unit as of December 31st, 2024 was 282. So my total cost per unit under absorption is going to be the 402 plus the 282 or $684 per unit. So right over here, this is going to be 684. Okay, so again, I sold 20,000 units. I have to take 20,000 units to cost of goods sold. Over here, because it's FIFO, the first goods in are the first ones expensed to cost of goods sold. So I'm going to take what is in my ending inventory first. Now, my current year production of units, how many am I going to go through and take? Well, I produced 19,000, but do I need all 19? No, I only need 15,000 units. Now, for this part over here is when I'm looking at my per unit, got to try to figure this out for these 15,000 units. When I'm going over here and I'm looking at my per unit, I know that my total variable costs per unit was 373. However, that does not include fixed factory overhead. So what I'm going to need to do is I'm going to need to take my fixed factory overhead. Okay, and as of 12/31/25, how much was that? Well, over here, under variable costing, remember, we expense all of the fixed factory overhead. So my total fixed factory overhead during the year of 2025 was 5.3 million. Okay. Now, for the number of units produced, so the number of units that I produced during 2025 is going to be 19,000 units. So my fixed factory overhead per unit is not a nice round number, but that's okay. We'll just go ahead and use this number right over here. So I get 279 per unit. So my total cost per unit under absorption costing is going to be 652 for this 12/31/25. Okay, so remember, if the numbers don't exactly work out at the end, we'll kind of understand why. So my total cost of goods sold under absorption costing is going to be 5,000 times 684, 15,000 times 652. So my total cost of goods sold right over here is going to be 13,199,211. Okay, so my gross profit under absorption costing for this year is going to be 17 million minus 13,199,211. Okay, now what do I do next? Less my selling, general, and administrative costs. So what are those going to be? It is going to be my sales commissions. My sales commissions were 460,000. My fixed SG&A is going to be over here of 1.2 million. So my total SG&A is going to be right over here of 1,660,000. So my net income under absorption costing is going to be 3,800,789 less my SG&A of 1,660,000. Okay, that was for 12/31/25. Let's go ahead and now do this for 12/31/26. Okay, now when I look over here, my sales are going to be exactly the same as they were for variable costing, are 25,500,000. My per unit has not changed. My sales price per unit is 850. So the number of units that I sold must have been 30,000 units. Okay. So now what do I do next? I've got my cost of goods sold under absorption. Because I'm using FIFO, I need to do a quick determination. When I look at the units, right, I had my ending inventory as of 12/31/24 became my beginning inventory as of 5/21/25. But as I saw up here, I already went through and I expensed those. So the real question is, how many units do I have in my beginning inventory? Because when I do FIFO, or first in, first out, I'm going to need to take my beginning inventory in terms of units. Let's figure this out. So I had ending inventory of 5,000 from 12/31/24. I produced 19,000 units. Okay, so I had a total over here of 24,000, but I sold 20,000 units. And when I sold them, where did I take it from? Well, I first took it from this ending inventory, and then I took what I needed from the produced, or I took 15,000 units. So I have ending inventory of 4,000 units. So I sold 20,000. So I have ending inventory of 4,000 units. Now, what is the cost of those 4,000 units? It's going to be right over here. It's my total cost per unit under absorption costing, or this 652. The 684 is not applicable because I already took those to cost of goods sold last year. So my beginning inventory, I had 4,000 units, And this is going to be at a per unit cost of 652, or the crazy number, because I didn't check my numbers before I started this, but this is my third take on the video. Okay, so I'm almost there. If I sold 30,000 units, I take 4,000 from my beginning inventory, which is this cost right over here. Okay, now what I need to go through and do is I now need to get the current year production amounts. So my current year production, I need to take 26,000 units. I sold 30. I already got 4,000 from beginning inventory, so I need another 26,000. So what I now need to figure out is, what was my fixed factory overhead for 2026? Well, my fixed factory overhead for 2026 was 8,460,000. My units produced were 29,000 units. So my cost per unit, it's going to be a nice uneven number. Sorry about that, kids. There's nobody was harmed in the making this video, but I'm not going to redo it. So right over here, I've got 291.72. So this number here is going to become my new fixed factory overhead per unit. Remember, in my cost of goods sold under absorption costing, right, what's going to happen? Well, what's going to happen is I'm not only going to have what's under for variable, right? What I'm also going to have over here is what is going to be the amount under absorption. So I got to include that fixed factory overhead per unit. So over here, this total cost here is 707. Okay, so my total cost of goods sold under absorption costing is going to be 2,607,789 and 18,374,827. So my total cost of goods sold under absorption is going to be 20,982. Now, in terms of my variable costs, right over here, what am I going to have? Well, I'm going to have my sales commissions. So this would be less SG&A. So my first part over here is I'm going to have my sales commissions. My sales commissions for this particular question were 690,000. My fixed SG&A is going to be right over here at 1.4 million. So my total SG&A is going to be, and again, I forgot a really critical element. I'm doing this all the time. I don't know what it is. I don't like disgusting profit, but I do like gross profit. Okay. So my gross profit under absorption is going to be 25,500,000 minus 20,982 for 4,517. Okay. So over here, my net income under absorption costing is going to be 4,517,383 minus 2,090 in total. Okay. What we're going to do, kids, is I'm going to go ahead and end this video here, and I'm going to make another video, part two. It's exciting, where we're going to go through and we're going to go through and identify what these differences are. So I'll see you on the next video. Have a great rest of your day.